Let's talk about student-centered and personally relevant learning. The reason this is important is that girls become motivated when they feel their project or task is important and that they can make a difference. SciGirls strategies say that when we support them using STEM as a tool, they begin to learn about these topics that they're working on. But personal relevance can be complicated when you consider the multiple identities that girls and indeed all students inhabit as they navigate school. There are many different identities that a student has when they enter a space: culture, race, gender, being three. The benefits are that if girls can see how STEM is relevant in their own lives and their own interests, then their attraction to these subjects is likely to increase. So how can you do this? There are a lot of great crossover benefits when you start thinking about how to make learning student-centered as well as culturally relevant or culturally responsive. But before we do that, we should agree on some terms. So we hear these terms a lot in education. We hear about understanding culture. We need to understand what it means to use culturally relevant or culturally responsive practices. We need to understand what we mean by student-centered. What does that look like? How is learning meaningful? How are students motivated and engaged? So obviously culture is something that we need to think about as what an individual brings into the classroom and their lives outside of the classroom. Gloria Ladson-Billings brought forward the idea of pedagogy around thinking of how to make education culturally relevant. She has three principles of culturally relevant practices. First is that students must experience academic success. Second, students must develop and or maintain their own cultural competence in the classroom. And finally, students must develop a critical consciousness through which they challenge the status quo of the current social order. Things that you can do and that you're probably seeing and doing in lots of different ways include communicating to all of your students that you have high expectations of their learning. Use active teaching methods. Instead of standing in the front and lecturing for an entire 90 minutes, move around the room, work with small groups, work with students individually. Have students use active learning methods as well. Think of yourself as a facilitator, a guide on the side, as opposed to the sage on the stage. Include your culturally and linguistically diverse students when you design your lessons. What kinds of things will you need to consider? Well, if you don't know, your students are your best resource. Ask them, how does this relate to you? What do you understand? An example of this might be in a science class where students are understanding boiling point and they're boiling water. Well, why would they need to know that? Maybe boiling rice would be an example, something that they see or have done in their own homes. Another thing to be aware of is your own cultural sensitivity. What do you know about your own culture? How are you aware of how your culture fits in your classroom and with the diversity of the students that you're working with? Reshaping your curriculum and delivery of services is a way that we can think about culturally relevant practices, including things in your curriculum that would be representative of more than just your culture or the culture of science. When students can control the discourse in the classroom, those student-led conversations, those student-to-student argumentative conversations, that is another great way to provide culturally relevant practices. When students hear another student talking about their understanding of science, they might learn something different than if they've heard it from you, the teacher, or read it in a book. And then considering small group instruction. Working with small groups, having small groups do small group projects are ways to increase student-centered instruction as well as culturally relevant practices. So how do you know what's relevant and student-centered? Your best resource is your learners. Ask your students. Shared learning experiences is another way that you can increase the relevancy of the lessons that you're teaching. So perhaps you do a demonstration using a fish tank, asking students to predict whether a piece of fruit will sink or float before you put it in. Then students observe and have to explain why they think it happened. So you put the apple in, the apple floats. Students need to explain why they think it's floating. And of course, we can talk about density, we can talk about buoyancy, and all kinds of different science content. But what's important is having students voice their ideas out loud to one another And it's okay to be wrong. It's okay to make the wrong prediction. It's the more important part is being able to explain what they observe. Ask students then to also share examples from their own lives that connects the science content to the classroom. This is a great way to bring relevancy into the class. It might help other students see the connections as well. I mentioned students working in small groups. This is a terrific way for students to have those conversations themselves. They can find the relevance themselves. So using strategies like these, thinking about student-centered learning and culturally relevant practices, can empower both educators and learners.